Hi guys, right now it is the holidays for us, which means that I could upload more than one video. Whoop, whoop. Okay, so I did post a video on Monday over on my second channel. I'll put a link to that down below, or it will be on the little end card, but it was just a little vlog. But today, I thought I haven't done a DIY video in a little while, and I just happened to cut my jeans shorter. So I made this really cute bow scrunchie thing, because first of all, I love bows, and second of all, I don't leave the house without a hair tie. So I was like, what's the point of having like a bow where you just clip on your head rather than putting a bow onto a scrunchie? So this will just be on my wrist like this, and that's really cute. It'll just accessorize. Like, you don't even have to wear this as a proper hair tie. You can just wear it as a bracelet and no one would even know. So I had made these ones out of a pair of black and brown stripy jeans that I had cut shorter because it was too long for me, and I thought that they would be perfect color because at school we're not allowed to wear like really random colors, even though like I don't really have that much to go for school. But I have this one, which is just black and it has brown stripes on the middle, and no, the stripes do not like go right through to the middle, it's just like the sides, and there was some brown on the side over here, but I was like, probably not. You can see from like the middle that it's like got the brown bits like here. But yeah, I thought this was a really cute idea, and instead of having a clip, and besides, who carries a clip around? You can't exactly clip on like a bow into your skin. So I was like, might be a good idea to put it into a little scrunchie. So first of all, this is recycling material. Like, you don't even have to go out and buy some stuff. If you have like old shorts that you can't fit anymore, jeans that you're too big, that are too big for you, that you want to cut the bottoms off, or they're too small for you, then this is like the perfect DIY for you. Again, it's like so easy to do and there is no sewing required, but I thought this was a really cute idea, and it's just like something I would wear like every single day. So if you guys want to know how to make this, well, keep watching, and without further ado, let's get started. Okay, so for the first bit of the video, you will obviously want to know what you need. So the first thing is to grab the material that you want to use. This is the stripy material that I used for my first bow, but you could use whatever you want, like denim that you cut off. You'll need a ruler, some fabric glue. This is the Craft Smart that I got from Spotlight for a few dollars. A paintbrush to glue all your things together, and this is the next optional one, is just some studs because I want to put studs in the next bow. A plastic bag just to cover up the area that you're going to be gluing on so that none of the glue gets onto the carpet. And fabric scissors. Now, I prefer fabric scissors over normal scissors because they cut better and it gives more of a clean edge than normal scissors. So what you want to do is grab your plastic bag and lay it on the floor so that none of the glue gets into the carpet. Now grab your material. Now I'm going to be using this blue material instead of the stripy one, and right now I'm actually just measuring out how big my stripy one was, just to get a clear indication of how big I wanted the bow. So this one is actually 12 centimeters, but when I was making the bow I wasn't measuring it out. So for this one I actually made it slightly bigger, about 14 centimeters, which meant that I just cut off a small bit of the end of my jeans, and as you can see there actually is a crease on the jeans already that was there like when I rolled up my jeans. So I just used that crease to cut through it, and right now I'm just cutting through it. Now what I'm doing here is I just turn my denim jeans piece inside out. so that I could easily know where the seams are so that I can cut just the top part of it off. I'm not using both of this material because it makes it harder to work with because it's so thick. So what I'm doing is I'm just cutting along the seams of both sides so that I have a flat piece of denim fabric. And now what I'm doing is I'm placing it directly flat on the plastic bag, and now I'm just grabbing my paintbrush and before I start gluing, folding the material in half so that I know how much I am leaving when I start to put the studs in. But for now, I'm just seeing how big the overall bow is going to be by folding in half, and right now I'm just kind of fiddling around on how big the bow is going to look when it's scrunched up together. Now I am just folding the sides a little in. I didn't really measure this bit, but it's probably around 5 centimeters or so. I kind of just approximated, and with my fabric glue I just poured some onto the plastic bag and started and using only a little bit, it covers up heaps. So just grabbing my paintbrush, I am going to dab little bits of it on the edges, and eventually this will stop the edges from fraying when you have the bow on. Doing after all that is done is just folding in half again so that I have a clear crease on where to start and stop, because now I am adding in the studs. Now if you guys live in New Zealand like me, they get confused on when you say studs. They'll probably give you like earring studs, so when you want to go ask them what they are called brads. Now when I got these, they were only $2 a packet because they're on sale, so go ahead and go through those $1, $2 marked bins inside Spotlight or your local craft store, and they would have heaps of them. I went out and grabbed so many, but I thought that the gold square ones would look pretty cute with this bow, so that is what I'm going to do now. How you insert the studs is that there are clips at the back, and you just push them through the denim, and there are they're like split pins, so when you turn them over, all you need to do is push the two pins back, and with a pair of scissors just push them down more securely. So just put this, do this on a flat surface and push them down, this way they won't fall off. If I could hold ya, once I finished all the studs, I ended up having 6 on each side, so I only used 12. So now what I'm doing is folding it up again, and this time I am gluing the two sides together. Now this is going to be quite hard because you have to fill up that whole square space or rectangular space in the other side so that the studs do not fall off. And the thing you need to focus on here are the sides, because you don't want your sides to be flying up. So right now I'm just gluing the sides together, and this will just secure the entire bow. So once you've glued the two sides together, I am just folding the middle together, which is just grabbing one and folding it like you would do for like a little paper lantern, just inside outside inside outside, and just flip them and fold them together. And then fix the size of your bow so that you know what it will look like when it's finished, and pinch through the middle together. So basically it's a pinching motion. Now what I'm doing here is I'm grabbing some leftover denim material, and I am cutting it up in half. And I know I shouldn't tell you, but I just can't stop thinking of you. Wherever you are, you. Now that I got the desired look that I want to have for my bow, I am just measuring out how big it would be on my final bow. So now what I'm doing is that I'm gluing down the bits that I pinched down so that it will be more secure and that they won't fall off if any of the bits fall off, like the swing sheet or the middle bit of my bow. Nothing that compares to what we had, and so I walk alone. Now after doing all of that, I am starting to put the strap down the middle. Now you want to have the strap come down the front first and not the back. So the end of your piece should be on the top and it will fall down to the front first, and then pinching it down so that it's all secure. And with your hair tie, you are placing this in the middle of your bow so that it is placed in the middle and not like to the left or to the right, because otherwise it would not look great. So what I'm doing is just gluing the middle piece of the bow and then putting the hair tie on top of it so that later on it won't come off and will stay secure. Now for the rest of this, I'm just wrapping around the remaining of the little strip that I had cut off. It doesn't matter how long it is at this point, but you would know how long is too long. So I think I wrapped it around about 3 or 4 times until the end of my strap was finished, so that the end of the strap was at the bottom of the bow. Now when I say top and bottom, I am talking about it with the bow facing you and not facing away from you. So I'm just placing the glue left onto the bow and then cutting off any unnecessary fraying or excess denim that I have, and you are now finished. So this takes 5 minutes to dry, because it's on the bottle I read that it takes about 5 minutes to dry. So what I am doing now is that I am just fixing the bow so that when it dries up it kind of stays its shape rather than a scrunched up piece of material. And I actually glued just some extra bits on there, so, and what's so great about this glue is that it dries clear, so you don't see any glue that is like white or anything on your bow, so that's all good. And what I did to the bow so that they scrunchie that you have on your bow does not flop or turn some random direction is that I put this lid back onto the glue and just pop the hair tie onto it so that when it dries the hair tie stays in place. And this is the final product. Obviously this one is a lot bigger than the stripy one that I made earlier. Obviously you can do whatever size you want depending on how big or how little your bow is. You can make it even smaller if you wanted to, or you can make it as bigger than, like, as big as this one. Obviously this one is bigger, and I reckon that the bigger the bows, it's depending on like how big of a statement piece you want to make. So as for this one, I think this would be cute on like little tie up, like a little half a puff down out do. For this one, I reckon I might do this in like a little bun, so like a really big top knot bun on the top, and then just put this on the bottom. I like to wear my scrunchies like after I do my bun, so like I'll just tie my hair up with one hair tie and then use this to put the bun together. Obviously this one's a bit different to this one because I added in the studs. But you could always do whatever you want. You can add in a ribbon that would like come in through here, like before you fold it up, so it'll be two different colored, or you can choose more than one colored denim, like you can use a maroon and a brown, or a colored one, because I know there's a lot of colored jeans around. But I think this is a really cute look, and obviously you can wear this around wherever, and especially because this is a neutral color, you can wear it with whatever you want. So yeah, the method is all the same, but depending on what you want to add onto the bow is your choice. So these are the two bows that I have made. I probably will make more because I have so many left over. But if you guys enjoyed this video, please give this video a massive thumbs up. That is down there somewhere, I think. And comment below if you guys want me to do more DIY videos. Give a video response if you try this out. Like, honestly, if you try this out and give me a video response, you're amazing. And give me more suggestions on what more DIYs I could do down below. I do have another DIY coming up next week that I want to show you guys right now, but it's gonna be a surprise. So if you guys want me to do more DIYs, obviously click the like button, subscribe to my channel so that you can see all the videos, comment below whatever DIYs you want me to do next, and if you do a video response as well. And yeah, so my channel is basically all vlogs and DIYs and just little challenges and things like that. And if you guys enjoy it, hopefully you guys will stick around and subscribe. So thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you guys next time. Bye! I love bows. And second of all, I don't go anywhere without a hair tie. I don't even know what I'm doing. Look at my shirt, guys. It's Lego Star Wars. I don't even like Star Wars. What is this? Nah, kidding. I was just, yeah, it's a really baggy shirt. It's a holiday, let me be. It's really cute. I think I should like, thumbnail. Okay, I don't even know what I'm doing. Let's get started. Not as big, like bigger than us if you wanted to. Okay.